kau. Uliniwachami bila faham kuania kozam angalau. Ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi. Labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, ndio, tutaonana baadaye. Mpendwa, ndio, tutaonana baadaye. Nakama, nakama, mpendwa, tabasamu. Tutaonana baadaye. Hey, nakama, nakama, mpendwa, tabasamu. Tutaonana baadaye.
Wow. Okay. Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Akima ulana, ingilia kati. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani. Kushoto kulia unakujalini. Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliye kuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi, nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja. But kauna raka, nenda kwanza. Niko na Ibax sijalala. Na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Utaona na baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana.
Mi bila faham kuania kozam angalau. Ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi. Labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, ndio,
okay. Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upena notice. Aki Maulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia, unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Iri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana patai, oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana patai, ndio. Ndio. Tutaonana patai, oh, nakamu nakamu.
Fahamu kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu, nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi. Labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Ndio. Tutaonana baadaye. Mwendwa ndio.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upena notice. Aki Maulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia, unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Iri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana patai, oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana. salimu maulana, taonana baadaye. Ndio ndio tutaonana baadaye. Oh, na kama na kama mpendwa tabasamu, tutaonana baadaye.
Kozam angalau ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Aki maulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwanini, uliamua kutangulia. Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani. Kushoto kulia unakuja lini. Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliye kuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi, nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka, nenda kwanza. Niko na ibak sijalala, na usalimie maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu maulana, taonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu maulana, taonana baadaye. Oh, na kama, mpendwa tabasamu.
sasa tutaonana baadaye.
Mi bila faham kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Aki Maulana, ingilia kati. This ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Diet yangu imechange, tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia. Unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana.
Kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Aki Maulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwanini uliamua kutangulia? Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia, unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena, unanitenda. Aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Kozam angalau ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Tutaonana baadaye.
okay. Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upena notice. Akimaulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana baadaye. Ndio. Ndio. Tutaonana baadaye.
Fahamu kuwa ni yako zamu. Angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu. Nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi. Labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Ndio. Tutaonana baadaye. Mpendwa ndio. Tutaonana baadaye. Nakamna kama mpendwa tabasamu. Tutaonana baadaye. Hey, nakamna kama mpendwa tabasamu. Tutaonana baadaye.
Wow. Okay. Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upena notice. Akimaulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana. tutaonana baadaye.
Fahamu kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu, nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salamu, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Usafiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Ndio, tutaonana baadaye. Wendwa ndio, tutaonana baadaye. Na kama penda tabasamu, tutaonana baadaye. Na kama penda tabasamu, tutaonana baadaye.
Wow. Okay. Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upena notice. Kimaulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwanini, uliamua kutangulia. Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani. Kushoto kulia unakuja lini. Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliye kuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi, nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja. But kauna raka, nenda kwanza. Niko na Ibax sijalala. Na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana.
uliniwacha mi bila fahamu, kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakam, nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upena notice. Akimaulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Diet yangu imechange, tabia kulea, usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia, unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena, unanitenda. Aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibak sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
sana. Nataka kwa sababu ya jinsi ya masaa yetu amesonga sana, tukaweza kuanza programu yetu siku ya leo. Na kabla ya sisi kile, nataka kumkaribisha Mama Lydia aje aweze kuongoza kwa maombi ili tukaweze kuanza. Karibu sana.
that of my own mother. But if I had to, I'll describe my mother as still on life and very direct. She was a woman who was not afraid to go after what she wanted in life, and it was clear by the way she lived. From her stories and pictures, Mom was adventurous. In 1974, at 24 years of age, Mom came from Kenya and Kilimanjaro, accompanied by her only friend and without a quarter of bread. And it was her first time seeing snow. This was quite uncommon for longer than that time, let alone challenging, and accomplishing something few her age would boast about, as those who have climbed either of these mountains may very well know, me included. I don't think most people could comprehend just how rare it was that at 1974, a young black woman from Kenya, no less, would think about let alone climb these mountains. It was a feat, of course, that is fully described her spirit. One of adventure, one of wonder, and freedom. This would make such an impression on me at a young age. And I remember telling her, I would also like to travel the world and see snow. To which she replied, what for? You can experience it here at home. Go climb Mount Kenya. You get all the snow you want. That was not for you. Mom went backpacking on a motorcycle across the US with a couple of her friends. Well, they pitched their tents, and I don't know how many of you can say the same, but that's what we millennials call young, wild, and free. Or simply, badass. Even in the last months, when Mom was at the coast, she would make it a habit to sleep every Sunday at the ocean. And many people around her would be surprised that she was a really good swimmer, something which is not common with people her age. She pushed the limits on what a young black woman could do, and her love for photography was one of them. At any kind of occasion, Mom would get her old Canon camera, capturing every moment, and say, you look back and thank me for them for recording this moment. And that we did. As I was going through her photos, I was like, you have lived a full life. Now, reading, that was a favorite thing to do. I remember a big collection of every issue of the National Geographic magazines from 1978 to 1994. This, she said, was a way to travel and see the wonders of the world. It was a joy to watch her immerse herself in biographies, autobiographies, and literature and history books. Naturally, she became a publisher at the University of Nairobi. And in her own words, she said, my job allows me to read numerous books of diverse interesting topics. Of course, she was getting paid for that. Mom loved Christ and was a devout follower, and she enjoyed Mass so much that even when the COVID-19 pandemic hit, she made sure she followed Mass every Sunday on TV. Without doubt, one of her proudest moments was when she became a member of the Christian Women's Association, CWA. Her volunteer work also was her pride and joy, and she did it with great humility and joy in her heart. Taking care of her little Shamba at home brought her daily joy as she planted her favorite vegetables and herbs. And anyone can tell her proud should of the fact. So how do you describe her lifetime? My mother's lifetime. I possibly can't, found me the heart of love, love of home, chose my home, my inspiration, and my truth. I cannot find it in me to describe this to the fullest. Her impact on my life is evident. Following in her footsteps, I love adventure, and any time I go on my trips, she always worry, and it will be her friends that should remind her that the cable does not fall far from the tree. She'll then proudly share my pictures and videos after going for my adventures. I would stand here and say, if only I could be half the woman she was, but she taught me better than that. She taught me grace, humility, and kindness. She taught me about what else, to be myself, to do what makes me happy, and to live my life to the fullest. And for that, I am forever grateful. Her life exemplified the spirit of strength and bravery. But I came to learn that this was stemmed from everyday actions of humility, patience, and love. Mama, I will miss you. I will love you. And I will remember you. Till you meet again.
Goodbye, Mom.
Amanda.
She lived life to the fullest and did not shy away from adventure. And like me, I did not like adventure, and I am not going to participate in it. But I just followed the footsteps of mom. My mother knew when something was amiss, and she would hug me for a long period of time, and she would cry, and she let me cry on her bosom like a small child. I was a small child. I will miss her listening ear. Mom was such a good listener. Mom was slow to anger, very slow. I remember when I was learning to drive a car, I hit her car and realized that I had found it like that at the parking lot. Mom knew I was lying, and she never got angry at me. But she gave me less allowance that month so that she could repair her car. This was an honesty and trust lesson for me. The love that mom gave me, and showed me has helped me be a good mom to my kids, or so I want to believe. I can never match up to her, but I try to. Mom loved her grandchildren, and she called and talked with Raina very often. Raina is my daughter, my firstborn. And the conversation always ended with, "Shosho, I miss you and I love you very much." My daughter's first steps were taken in Buruburu, with mom being there. I had traveled out for work and I could not be there. My daughter had to go and stay with mom. And when she started learning how to walk, mom was so excited that she took her video and sent it to me. She used to record everything. Their bond was special. Recently, when mom was in Mombasa, and she talked to Raina on the phone and told her that she was in Mombasa, Raina started crying on the phone because she thought sharks were going to eat her shosho. Mom had to calm her down and promised to come visit her on the 7th of May, the last Saturday, but this was never meant to be. My mom was the truest, dearest, and more than a mother to me. You are special and a rare gift from God. Mom, you possess so much grace, patience, and love. You gave me and my children a home. We shall forever miss coming to Shoshowabubu, as Raina would call her, because she does not know how to pronounce Buruburu. What we have once enjoyed deeply, we can never lose. All that we love deeply becomes part of us. Mom, rest easy. We shall meet again. Thank you.
Praise God. Yes, I'm Timothy, the husband. That is my mother-in-law. And I'm going to read my tribute. A mother, a friend, grandma to my kids. Since I met your beautiful daughter, Omboy, from the first day she told me, "Come and meet my mom. She's an amazing woman." I said to her, maybe she did not like me, but she kept on showering her with praises. Finally, when she introduced me to her, true to her word, she was an amazing lady. She took me in as a son, wholeheartedly. We became friends. She didn't miss her words. When I was wrong, or when I was right, she would tell me. We shared great moments. We went for family holidays together, which I don't think most people go with their mother-in-law. But we went with her and the kids, and both of them. We had so much fun. True, she was an amazing grandma. Today and Raina, I promise I will teach them your good ways. She was the most accommodating person and a great host. Since I started visiting her home, there was no time that I went there and found no guests. The guests were always happy, and you could tell they were welcome.
please come find some of your students, your brothers and sisters running.
God is good.
We met in Mombasa when we were
1992, Gordon, and her master's degree in literature at the University of Nairobi, where she later earned her postgraduate degree in mass education at the School of Journalism at the same University of Nairobi. Gordon was undertaking her PhD course in mass education at the University of Agriculture Technology. She did not have a chance to finish this. About her family, Pauline was a loving mother to have a boy with her, and Gladys was minor about her. She was a mother-in-law to Timothy, okay? And a nothing grandmother to Raina. She was a loving aunt to me and to many others. About her church and her faith, Pauline was the voting follower of the Catholic Church. She was baptized in Kerengi in Maria Botini's Mara County, where she took her first calling in. And also where she was confirmed in 1957. She was an active member of the church. She was a member of various groups and associations, including the Catholic Women Association, CFA. Pauline was a prayerful and loving person. She was a vice chair. A single mother's support group, commonly referred to as Life Goes On, in short, LGO. The group met and meets in their homes on a monthly basis to support each other spiritually, socially, and also financially. She died an active member of the Zito Premier, a prayer group between her neighbors at the Lord Festival. She was a member of the Mountain Group, a self-help group, where she served as a secretary. Her occupation. In 1968, after the completion of her O-level as the fourth form, due to her exemplary performance, she got a temporary job at Barclays Bank, now called Absa, in Kisumu. After that stint in Barclays Bank, she joined the Teacher Service Commission from 1971 for 15 years, where she taught English and literature in several secondary schools, including her first posting in the computer sector.
Might live a new life united with him by blindness to his death, so shall we be united with him by blindness to his resurrection. On the day of the baptism you put on Christ, on the day of Christ's coming, let him be clothed with glory. His last through Christ on the world. Now proceed to the church of the body.
Maria, 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 Maria. the last, will take his stand on earth. After my awakening, he will set me close to him. And from my flesh, I shall look on God. He whom I shall see will take my part. His eyes will gaze on him and find him not a good.
The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
light. Theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy are you when people abuse you and persecute you and speak all kinds of calumny against you on their account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward will be great in heaven. The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Praise
you,
Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, dear friends. God is good. And all the time. How many would want to see God? I try. Very good. How many would want to die? I'm serious, Chris. It's amazing that we would want to see God. But even more amazing that we do not want to die. And I think we are here so that we can reflect on that we do not want. The reality of death. There are so many things that are ordinary in our lives. And ordinary things are taken for granted. Because if anything, they are ordinary. Life itself, the way we live it, is somehow ordinary. We think that it is ordinary to wake up and to sleep in the evening. We think it's ordinary because even after this funeral, we have plans. God is good. I have plans and dreams. In the parish I work in, that's a sacrament. And I'm sure even you have plans for today. You have your diaries for this week, and you have activities to accomplish. And to a great extent, you assume that it will happen, if anything is ordinary. But what is ordinary becomes extraordinary and super ordinary. When death strikes, there are many things around us that we take for granted. Our families, for example, the future we have, the presence of our parents, the presence of our siblings, it's an ordinary thing. If anything, I was part of a family, and we take it for granted. The peace in our nation, for example. The structures put by government, we take for granted that probably we talk very badly about governments and states. It's ordinary. It's ordinary to drive to a hospital. The masses are there, or can be there. It's important to know that for me to be here, I have to drive and pass the roads that governments make. And I'm not still trying to talk good about governments, but I'm trying to indicate how sometimes we find ourselves in things happening and we see it as early life. We take for granted even the peace that we experience, not forgetting that our country can become, probably, a Somalia in quotes. But probably, the structures do not sustain our lives. All I'm saying is because human beings, the ordinariness of life, take things for granted. Human beings in ordinariness of life forget about God. Because just as we forget about the facilities around us and the favors that we have, we also forget about the beginning of our life, God Himself. It is within our knowledge that we are dying when we do not know. But we never take time to think about the reality of death. Worry that you are bending fear about you today. Woke up like any one of us, strong and in plans, not knowing that by 1:30 she will be in the other world. She went into errands. She wanted to go to town to pay for some blood in somewhere. Because it's ordinary to eat. It is within our plans. But it didn't come to fruition. Because the moment that God needed her came to be.
goes with that, and as we celebrate tithe, it's an invitation for us to take time and look at the very fundamental things that Jesus has taught us and make us have the dignity of humanity, the dignity that we have, and what can go beyond the price we have and usher us into eternity. My dear friends, we are here because we knew this woman, either directly or indirectly. We have interacted with her. She was one of us, and what she is, we are becoming. And I suppose when she lays there, she's inviting us to pause and reflect about our lives. And above all, reflect about our lives in relation to God who matters. To her now, nothing matters. All the achievements, the degree she had, even the PhD that she didn't accomplish, is not important. What matters is the union that she cultivated in her earthly life with her God. In situations like this, and when one of us is taken from us, and when the ordinariness is changed to extraordinariness, and this is what we are experiencing now, then we pause and reflect about our lives, the limitedness of it, and how it can be made perfect. And the only one who can make it perfect is God Himself. Like many of us, as we go through difficult times, Pastor Hugh being there, Job went through a very difficult situation. He was a wealthy man, as you know, and you heard about him in the first reading. He believed in God. He was a faithful man. In fact, even when God would have a conversation with Satan, I didn't know that God would have a conversation with Satan. But I only know one thing, that God loves Satan as He loves me, because God is love. God is good. Yes, we had a conversation. Yes, as we had a conversation with Him. And He called us, Satan. Oh, you are going around there in the world. Because in the world, in human beings, we have God, and we have Satan. So he was going around, and you know, he must be visiting some people. God is good. To see the Christ. Satan must have been coming to visit some people. And you have to walk and get into some room, you should die. So I was having any other sister. I don't even know that they don't want to die. Sometimes we come to be Satan, and sometimes we endeavor to be God. So he says, I was in the world. And as I was going around, God asks, before you post, when you were going around the earth, did you meet with my servant, Job? Yes, that great man that I'm very proud about. Because when God was trying to talk about Job, he saw a man after his heart. A man who was a representation of God and a manifestation of God. And what is Satan telling you? Because I know you don't ask him. Oh yes, that man you are saying is so good and you are very proud about him. It is because you have given him everything he needs. In other words, he's flourishing in life like you and me. Because now you have good health. And that is why you don't have paraclass. God is good. So yes, you have given CPS in Christ. Who would you be? When the car that you used to drive there is taken by you with a car, what is good? When your house where you live is taken, when the great bread that you have is taken, when the good job that you do in is taken, when your mother is taken from you, when all these things and these titles that we hold are taken from us, what will we become? This was what was taken from God. Everything from children, sheep and cows and cattle and everything is wealth, and above all, his health. Worse still, when his wife will tell him something, you know what the wife told him? It's in regular. The wife told him, you know what? Get from her. Huyu Mungu nasema kali yake huyu mwana wewe mtesa mtusi. Kazi. Kazi ni ugali. You will be free from all these pains. It is from that that he wrote in his piece. And he said, how I wish that my words are written on the rock to be read through the ages. Of how I believe in God irrespective of everything. What I have chosen is God as my portion. Whether I have the glory, whether I have all the material wealth, whether I have names and titles, and they are taken away from me, my hope remains in God. Because I know He lives. Because I know it is He who makes me. Because I know He is what I choose. And He is my portion. How important it could be. It could be to be a king of sister. Yawera. Is it? Mamaida, yes, Mamaida. We are killing Mamaida. But you can continue to say that even in this situation, I choose God. Because even the way we are, by living here, all of us, it's just by His favor. That's why God is telling us how important it is to choose God at all times. And to commit ourselves to Him. Because when we are committed to God, we are just and fair. When we are committed to God, we live in gratitude. And even when we go through pain, we tell Him thank you. Because even in that pain, there is a favor. Even in this situation of the death of our mother here, a great woman, you know, who was taken from us, that there are still some favors that we can echo. And we can record, seeing that God is gracious to us. This is exactly what God is telling us. Reminding us also that life cannot be without pains. Pains are part and parcel of us. Because it is through going through these pains that we are consecrated for God. You know, in our times, there are things that you do not mention in public. You see, the Jesus Christ. Talk of public, especially to the youths, and they don't want to hear it from either. Talk of such things, they don't want to hear it. Talk of pain, talk of sorrow, talk of mourning, talk of hunger. You don't want to hear it. You don't want to associate with it. You want to be the world free of pain. You know what? In pain, there is some wealth hidden. Kuna utajiri ambao umefichwa katika uchungu. But that wealth can only be found by those who believe in God. When Jesus, in fact, the victor over death, nobody else conquered death other than Christ himself. When Jesus saw the multitude as I was seeing, and he was teaching them, he opened his mouth and he talked about happiness.
slain. In fact, he says, how happy are the poor in spirit? How happy? What you don't want to hear? For theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Happy the gentle. You know, in our times, even in our political arena, we have very few gentlemen and gentle ladies. We want to fight because we have our rights and we think it's good to fight. Because when we do not fight, we think we lose. We think we are not appreciated. We think we lose our greatness. Gentleness is that some of you people who really find happiness. To be gentle is to be humble. To be gentle is to, in a sense, suppress your will. To be gentle is to suspend my will and let the other so that I can act in a gentle manner with you. He talks about happy those who mourn. We mourn confronted by a painful experience of death. And he talks about it and says that there is some happiness in death. But there's a footage for this happiness to be experienced. Someone must have chosen God. Because God meets us and encounters in pain. Happy are those who hunger. We all have gone through the pains of hunger and the pains of hunger. And you know what? There is something hidden in hunger. And none of us here can indicate a particular hunger. We all have our desires. The desires we have and we are not getting it. And we are working so hard and we are not getting it. It's painful. But you know what? It is what gives us joy. It's what gives us meaning in life and purpose in life. That's why Jesus is saying, happy are those who hunger. Happy are the master. You cannot have master where there is no vulnerability. We are master to those who are vulnerable. And therefore, we are affected with them, sympathize with them, put ourselves in their shoes. Happy are the peacemakers. You cannot peacemake, you cannot make peace where there is no war. You know what? All these situations of pain and vulnerability becomes vehicles to eternity. Gives us a character, dignifies us, and makes us have a purpose of living. We are here celebrating this moment. In fact, my dear friends, let's reflect about this woman and the achievement that she has made. At least that the people eulogizing her and giving tributes to her. Whatever you have said about her, and whatever we are celebrating today, is because she was generous with her capacities. She allowed us to conceive our capacities and giftedness. That's why we're here. She had capacities, she gave back to two daughters. And out of it, the husbands have led us to their family.
She was sharp. In fact, she needed to share her sharpness and intelligence in teaching people. And that's why she didn't sit behind bands, behind the corridors of bands and doing whatever. Even though she had a job in bands, she wanted to go and teach. You know, teachers, Jesus was a teacher for your information. What is it? You see, the answer is Christian. And you are, when I talk about teachers sometimes, you say, oh, but they kept me younger pain. Or rather be a policeman and receive bribes rather than be a teacher. Jesus was a teacher and was crucified by policemen and nothing against policemen. What is this? You see, the answer is Christian. Rabbi indicated. And we are here celebrating this woman because she was gifted. She had capacities. But her capacities found value when she allowed them to be consumed by us human beings. And I suppose what she's teaching us is this, that the capacities and endowments we have are useless unless we allow people to consume them. I've been working in Blessed Sacrament for 11 years. These beautiful ladies can bear witness to that. And for the 11 years that I've been there, I have stayed in many places. Now I am leaving to support the next parish around here. And of the 11 years that I have lived in Blessed Sacrament, from Sunday, last Sunday, to today, are the most difficult days for me, and especially daily. Why? Because all the other priests also have been transferred, and I'm alone in the parish. So I'm getting to the house. And looking at that room in that house, I find it bare because no one is occupying it. I go to another one of the pastor's house, I find there is no one. I go to here for the men's house, there is no one. I go to here for our girl's house, there is no one. The only house or room that is life is the one that I want to buy. And it has come thinking to me. And has told me all the things that we have. Church is useless, and this year is someone who is living in meaning, a human being who consumes beauty. Eating is a problem when you are alone. We eat because we are anchored into communion, into community. And dear friends, this woman allowed herself in generosity to be used by us. And that's why we are celebrating her. How important it could be that each one of us would be happy. Happy when he's used by human beings. You know, when sometimes we say being used, we take it our own destiny. But I think it's only then when we are used by human beings, that we are destined to eternity. This woman is living eternally because she accepted to be used by us. Let us therefore allow ourselves to be used by each one of us. Let us allow ourselves to give our talents, our giftedness, to other people. Be to your husband. Be kind. Be kind to your husband. Amen. Be kind. Be kind to your wife. Amen. Be kind. This is important. Allow them to use you. Do not be so mean. Be generous. If you have followed, because I know there is someone here who is following this husband or his wife. Why? It's because you want
called the moment of rest. You will rest well because you allow the mind to use you. Let us allow ourselves to be used. Job allowed himself to be used. Used even by God and even by Satan. He was used by Satan. raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praises without end, we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord.
Ni hao ulini wacha mi
Thank you.
We humbly implore you, O Lord, for your departed servant, Pauline, that Christ, by the pastoral mysteries, she may glory in the gifts of the resurrection to come through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
As we stand,
yeah.
because I'm not an A at the end, but even then we are all the Master of Confucian Association. So thank you very much. I now want to take this opportunity on behalf of the Community of Blessed Sacrament to pass our condolences to the family of Pauline. You are in our prayers and very grateful for you. And I'm sure that God will give you grace at this very difficult time. I also want to take this opportunity to thank all of you for the participation and also for being in the family, because I believe that the presence of each one of us is a medicine that heals these souls of these great people at this very difficult time. And I'm sure that all of us are also invited to the value site, because it is important also to put soil back. So I'll accompany them to that end. I will also accompany them to that end. So all of you are invited, and I think you are finishing full time. You can hear without delay. So kindly, you can spend the evening and be there for these people. So just come and join them, because our presence is a medicine of their soul. So kindly be that medicine, the antidote that will help them stand at this time. I also want to take this opportunity to thank the Don Bosco, who have given this church to us so that we can be able to use it for this purpose. And we want to thank the administration, we want to thank the facilitators that facilitated us, and I am sure that God will always continue blessing them. Those many remarks, I invite you to stand up and have the blessing. And after that, you will exit. As we exit, there will be a portrait of the cross, and in fact, the family members, and then the CWA, and then all of us. The Lord be with you. Let God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. For the peace of our friends. For now we have to
kuniacha mi bila faham kuwa ni yako zam angalau ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Aki Maulana, ingilia kati. This ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Taonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana.
Faham kuwa ni yako zam angalau ungeniambia eti unakam nitulize ham wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, dear.
Okay. Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Akima ulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Diet yangu imechange, tabia kulea, usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia, unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kaa una raka, nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Utaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana.
Fahamu kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu, nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi. Labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Ndio. Tutaonana baadaye. Wendwa ndio.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Akima ulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Diet yangu imechange, tabia kulea, usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia, unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kaa una raka, nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana. Tutaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu
masa tutaonana
baadaye. Come, pendwa tabasamu, tutaonana baadaye. Mi bila faham kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Akimaulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwanini, uliamua kutangulia. Dayati yangu imechange. Tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia unakuja lini. Nitabasamu tena, unanitenda. Aliye kuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Joni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibag sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Oh, safiri salama, salimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Ni hao uliniwacha mi bila fahamu kuwa ni yako zamu, angalau ungeniambia eti unakamu nitulize hamu wangu wa dhati. Hey, tama zangu zimenikwamia mikononi, labda huu ni mwisho wa dunia. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye. Safiri salama, msalimu Maulana, tutaonana baadaye.
Natamani kujua what your plot is. Ata landlord upeana notice. Aki Maulana, ingilia kati. Peace ni expensive but worth it. Kwa nini uliamua kutangulia? Diet yangu imechange, tabia kulea usingizi na kutamani kushoto kulia. Unakuja lini? Nitabasamu tena. Unanitenda, aliyekuchukua sijui nani alimtuma. Maombi ni ati wakati rudi nyuma. Jioni nikirudi nikupate kwa nyumba. Jiji zimeshikana ni ngumu kuvunja, but kauna raka nenda kwanza. Niko na ibak sijalala, na usalimie Maulana.
Safiri salama, salimu Maulana, utaona.